Let's talk about rice. This is black rice, also sometimes known as purple rice or forbidden rice. It is a whole grain rice. How does it compare with the more common type of whole grain rice, brown rice? And how does it compare with the most commonly consumed type of rice in the world, white rice? Before I start, for those of you who are new to my channel, I am Dr. Chan. I am a medical doctor from Singapore. My work and my passion is in helping people in modifying their lifestyle and especially their eating habits to prevent and combat chronic diseases. Before I start my comparison of black versus brown versus white rice, let's first do a short revision on the taxonomy or scientific classification of different types of rice. The rice we consume are mostly from two subspecies, the Oryza sativa indica. Indica rice are often long grain, thin and fluffy. There are many different variety or cultivar of indica rice. Basmati rice and jasmine rice are two of the very popular indica rice that many of us in Asia, including here in Singapore, are familiar with. The other common subspecies of rice is the Oryza sativa japonica. Japonica rice are often short grain, rounder and thicker than the indica rice. Examples of Japonica rice are the arborio rice, often used in risotto, or the cow roast or koshihikari rice, often used in making sushi. White rice simply refers to refined grain rice, where the bran and germ layers of the rice grain is removed during rice processing. So, white rice can come from any variety or cultivar of rice. And there are thousands of different varieties of rice that are consumed around the world. So, whenever we talk about white rice, we are not referring to a specific variety or cultivar of rice, but are simply referring to the refined grain version of any of the thousands of different varieties of rice that people around the world consume. So, likewise, whole grain rice can come from any of the thousands of different variety or cultivars of rice. But because most of the varieties of rice consumed around the world are brown before they have their bran and germ layer removed during processing into white rice, people tend to use the term brown rice interchangeably with the term whole grain rice to mean the same thing, which is not quite correct. Because whole grain rice can also come in other colors, such as red or black rice. Let's talk a little bit about black rice. Black rice simply refers to whole grain rice that are black in color, and there are more than 200 varieties of rice that are black. So when someone talks about black rice, they are simply referring to whole grain rice that are black in color from any of these 200 over different cultivars of rice. Understanding this is important when we compare black rice versus brown rice versus white rice. Because when we do this comparison, we must know that we are comparing the hundreds of varieties of black rice versus the thousands of different varieties of brown and white rice. So when we compare the various nutrition profiles of different rice, we must first appreciate that the nutritional profile of each variety of rice is different, even when they are of the same color. And so when we compare black rice, brown rice, and white rice, we are comparing the nutrition profiles of hundreds of varieties of black rice with thousands of varieties of brown and white rice. So it is not helpful, nor even necessary, to go into the details of the specific values for each variety of rice of that color. So I've done a relative comparison table of black rice versus brown rice versus white rice based on these metrics instead. In terms of protein, fiber, vitamins and minerals content, black rice and brown rice are largely similar and are richer in them than white rice. When it comes to glycemic index, both black and brown rice, being whole grain and higher in fiber, generally have a lower GI or glycemic index than refined low fiber white rice. The GI of black and brown rice are usually in the low to medium GI range, with GI scores from the low 50s to 60s. One area that white rice does better than both black and brown rice is in the level of inorganic arsenic that they contain. Important to note that the levels of inorganic arsenic in rice differs based on a few different factors, especially where the rice is cultivated, what variety of rice, and also whether it is whole grain or refined. But in general, whole grain rice, for which both black rice and brown rice are, tend to have higher levels of inorganic arsenic than refined white rice, sometimes by as much as 2 times. But it's the inorganic arsenic levels in rice, and in whole grain rice in particular, a big concern. I shall not be covering this topic of arsenic in rice in this video. I have previously done a detailed video on this. You can go watch it if you are interested after this. I have put this video and other videos on rice-related topics in a playlist that I shall leave in the show notes below. When it comes to this subjective aspect of taste, I have a personal favorite. Now let's try the black rice. Very interesting. So many dimensions to this. It has not so much nutty, but berry, smoky, a tinge of sweetness. Very nice. That was from a video I did more than a year ago when I compared the texture and taste of different types of rice. I shall put the link to this video in the show notes below as well. When it comes to price and accessibility, black rice is the least common and the most expensive. You may not be able to find black rice in smaller supermarkets. Usually, you have to go to the bigger supermarkets or special grocery stores or online stores to get black rice. And the price of black rice can be a few times that of equivalent white rice. So, why do people pay so much more for black rice? What is so special about black rice? Other than its unique taste, which I personally like a lot, black rice stands out from other rice because of its high level of antioxidants. Black rice is very rich in anthocyanins, the phytochemicals found in deep, dark colored fruits and vegetables. Anthocyanins are known for its strong antioxidant as well as other health promoting properties. So this is how black rice, brown rice, white rice stack up in comparison. But we can also put it simply without going into the details. We can also see it this way, that brown rice is white rice plus more fiber, vitamins, minerals, and protein. And black rice is brown rice plus even more anthocyanins and antioxidants. One thing that I would like to emphasize is this. As much as it is useful to know about the differences in the nutritional profiles of different types of rice that we can choose to eat, and regardless of whether your personal choice of rice is white, brown, or black, and even though there are significant nutritional differences amongst them, even if your choice is white rice because you prefer white rice or are unable to switch to whole grain brown or black rice, it does not mean that there's nothing else you can do to improve your rice eating habits. Even if your choice is the nutrient and antioxidant richer whole grain brown or black rice, it also does not mean that there are no more room for improvement in your rice eating habits. Because we must be mindful that our choice of variety of rice is not the only thing that is important. What we eat with the rice when we eat rice is as important, if not even more important, than what type of rice we eat. To unlock the full potential of our lifestyle and eating habits, to prevent and combat diabetes, cardiovascular disease, and other lifestyle-related chronic diseases, we must do more than just focus on a particular aspect of a diet, such as our choice of staples or rice. We must look at, critically review, holistically, and then make the best informed choice to optimize all aspects of our eating habits. Rice-related topics is something I cover very extensively because rice is often the choice of staple and a big part of the dietary habits of my patients as well as workshop participants who come to me for dietary habits modification training and coaching. I shall leave the link to a playlist of all the videos I have done on rice and health-related topics in the show notes below. Do check it out. Let habits be thy medicine. I am Dr. Chan. Eat well and be well. Take care.